Tell us regarding some problems with the camel rearing tribes of Rajasthan. What the problem they are facing actually?
Sir, I'm not sure about the specific problems that they are facing today, but I can talk about the problems that the state as such is facing. So I feel that all the human development indicators of the state are very low. It is one of the Bimaru states, and I feel that camel herders would also be facing the same problems of illiteracy, low education, enrollment in schools would be low for both girls and boys, and then healthcare problems, and they may have to travel a lot, which would also make them a bit, if government provides them a little support financially to help them rear their camels in a better way, maybe that would help. And
recently one legislation has come in Rajasthan that slaughter of camel will be considered a crime under IPC and there will be imprisonment for 7 years, like that. So what are the far-reaching consequences of this legislation? And why this legislation has to come in picture? Rajasthan is a place where there are amalgamation of all sort of cultures. If you find Ganganagar, it is very much different from the Mandsaur area, and Talwar in that area. But still, what are the problems, peculiarities at the Ganganagar? Now, what are the problems at the near the Chittor area, Mandsaur region area, that area?
I'm sorry, sir. I've not stayed in Rajasthan, so I'm not aware of the specific problem.
Okay. You're not that much as everyone.
Yes, sir. So my father belongs to Rajasthan, but I lived in Delhi.
At which place you have stayed?
I beg your pardon, sir.
At which place you have stayed recently or late?
Sir, I have been staying in Delhi, except
in Delhi.
For 2 years when I was in
Ahmedabad. Okay. If I make a statement that green revolution in India has failed, it failed miserably, and the present society is having a heavy toll for the green revolution, effect of the revolution. How much will you agree with my statement?
Sir, I believe green revolution was not a total failure. Initially, it was able to provide to. It was able to make us self-sufficient, provide us food security. It was able to address the farmers' immediate problems of low productivity. It was able to give us high yields. However, in the long run, we find that the more use of pesticides has degraded the soil quality. It has use of hand pumps and tubers mostly has reduced the water level of the state of mostly Haryana and Punjab, and I feel it was concentrated only in the northern states, and while over time it should have adapted itself and should have spread to other states as well. And like today we know that it was not very environment friendly, so we should now focus on mitigating the harmful effects that the region is facing because of the wrong moves that we made then, and try to spread out green revolution not just in North India but in eastern part of our country as well, especially Northeast, and ensure that plus there is one more problem, that is that it was not very inclusive. There were farmers only with medium to high size land holdings who benefited the most, while the landless farmers or the farmers with very small land holdings did not benefit much. So now I think that because we know that majority of our farmers are small and marginal and rely on subsistence agriculture, we should be able to agricultural market, we see that today for our country to grow inclusively, we need our farmers also to develop, to grow, and to increase their income levels, to have better mechanization and high income sources. And I feel that
just see, I'm giving you one problem that in the Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh, there are a lot of suicide of the farmers.
Yes, sir.
But such type of suicides are being seldom reported in Bihar, West Bengal. Though these states are much poorer, resources are being less here. Those states like Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh are developed states. Why it is so? Why so much suicide there and why more suicide there? What are the reasons?
Sir, first I feel that Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh, yes, they are developed states, but the development is concentrated mostly to the cities. I feel that there are farmers who grow BT cotton and other such GM crops especially, they face this problem of using high inputs for in the farm and getting lower output. Plus, they are very heavily dependent on rainfall, which is very erratic. And they are in the clutches of the money lenders as well. So all these factors culminate into them becoming hopeless and wanting to commit suicide as the last resort. While in the poorer states like Bihar, they mostly rely on subsistence agriculture, which helps them meet their daily needs at least. And I feel that the input costs are maybe a little lesser that go into rice cultivation and jute cultivation as compared to those which go in BT cotton or other such crops that are grown in black soil in Maharashtra.
They supplement their income with migration also. They go somewhere else to get money.
Yes.
What is the problem at the Mexican Gulf? Mexican Gulf has become dead biologically. What is the problem?
Because of the oil spill.
You're sorry because you feel that you should have known that, or you are sorry because someone is asking you this question.
Sir, I'm sorry because you are asking this question and I don't know.
Okay. Well, the management education through which you have undergone, that is based on a completely different paradigm.
Yes.
Structure, structured. Marketing also, what is taught as part of a Western management paradigm is unstructured marketing.
Yes.
Indian management, whatever that it had taken place till some amount of time, had been very, very different from the management paradigm of the Western countries.
Yes.
Now, let us know the areas where the Indian and Western management practices differ. Which are the areas and why is it that they're going to differ? And make it structured.
Most of the Indian industries are industry businesses, especially the large ones, are family owned, and they still work in sort of a bureaucratic manner rather than working as a dynamic organization which adapts. Whereas the Western structures of organizations have evolved over a long period of time, many of them, and are more in a better position to compete as compared to the Indian ones. There are very few Indian companies which can be, which have proved themselves to be successful at a global level, whereas the Western companies have been fairly successful in their journey so far. You don't have to feel,
make it concrete. Right, we are not talking about feelings for some time, okay?
Yes.
Right?
Okay.
Try to remove this word from your language and then I am going to give you certain headings here. And just let me know what will be the Western form of management and Indian form of management.
Okay.
Agriculture.
Yes, agriculture in India.
Western would be
large land holdings with high mechanization and farmers are well off. Pretty well off and use subsidies from the government. Whereas on Indian side, it would be small or medium land holdings, farmers still using traditional methods of cultivation and heavy.
Lady, that's a characteristic. I'm talking about management. That's a characteristic. I'm talking about management.
Okay.
Are you getting my question? Okay, let's forget about it. Talk about marketing.
Okay.
Marketing, what exactly will be an Indian approach of management and the Western form of management?
Okay. So in India, we have APMC Act in agriculture.
Sorry?
You are talking specifically for agriculture.
No,
for
we are talking about marketing.
Okay.
Marketing as a tool of management. And how is it, what exactly the Western philosophy goes on to say, and what it Indian? What exactly is inscribed as part of Indian ethos as far as marketing is concerned? Western marketing is very different.
Okay.
Do you require a clue? Will it help you? Shouldn't you ask for it?
Yes.
Okay. Western marketing is structured, very structured. They have a goal. That is how they want to go ahead with it. Indian is now completed. I give you a hint.
They won't have a goal.
No, they do. They may want to be having it. But then completely unstructured, undercurrent. That is what they're going to say is referral marketing. This is in Western terminology what will be called as referral marketing. Is it not? That's a difference. When you want to talk about agriculture, then the Western form of agriculture goes on to talk about some type of a knowledge which is again based on large holdings and that uses no local wisdom at all. Indian is completely based on the use of local wisdom, local resources, as well as locally available materials. That's what has been in agriculture. Okay. Now pick up the last one. That is industry. if you have to define industrial action from a Western perspective and define industrial action from an Indian perspective, and that's not only from management, that is from any angle you can want to see it. How is it that you are going to be defining it from Western perspective and Eastern perspective?
From a Western perspective, industrialization.
Forget about Western Eastern. Just go to let me know what exactly is industrialization.
So industrialization would be when the society decides to moves its labor force from the agriculture into the into industries. Industries develop.
Okay, what are industries? What are industries? You have used the word, and I was harping on this. What exactly are industries? Is it that anyone who goes into manufacture this bottle will be an industry?
So industries work with a profit motive in mind. Western model is mostly capitalist based, wherein the owners of the industrial groups would try to maximize their profits while using the best possible way the resources that they have. While in India, the industrialization process has been largely supported by the government, especially in the initial phases after independence.
And what was, is it not that India was industrialized on the eve of the British coming to India?
Yes, sir, India was industrialized on...
India was or wasn't?
When the British came to India,
prior to that, was India industrialized or not?
So I don't say industrialized in the modern sense of the term, but rather...
Industrialized in the Western sense of the term.
Yes, sir. Not in the Western sense of the
okay.
term.
Okay.
Yes.
Because modern will go to become, will go include both of them, Indian as well as Western.
Yes.
Right? It was not... Okay, so how is it that you are going to define that finally?
Okay. Industrialized.
Should it be expected from a management instrument?
Yes, sir.
To put it in proper words?
Yes, sir.
Okay? So meet my expectation. Before we come to computer engineering?
Industrialization.
Okay, I go on to the video through. Is it that Mumbai's film industry is a part of industrialization? Is it industry?
So we call it an industry. Yes, sir, it's a part of industry.
Okay, take another example.
Yes.
Is it that IIT coaching to spread throughout the country is part of industry?
Yes.
Is it that civil services coaching is part of it?
Civil society.
Civil services coaching is part of it?
No, sir.
Okay, good. That's a good answer. Why? What makes IIT coaching part of industrialization and civil service coaching not?
So
the answer is correct. Give me an explanation.
Okay, sir. So IIT coaching...
You like to pass this question? Okay. Come to my last question. Okay? That is in computer engineering. When you're going to be having a lot of ICs on your board and their speed is also very high, what exactly is it that you're going to do that the conductivity is very high, plus they are getting a number of ICs on the board and they don't going to have a short circuiting as well? What is it that you're going to do? I say that you have a lot of integrated chips.
Yes, sir.
The greater the number of chips, the greater will be the speed,
yes,
computing speed. I mean, in any parallel processing, you're going to be having a good number of such type of ICs on the board.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Now that means that raises a question of whether they will go on to undergo for short circuiting or not, right?
Mm-hmm.
What exactly has been the development in the chip technology that goes on to prevent such type of short circuiting? I'm going to take one more liberty, right? Do you understand the meaning of, and can you differentiate the meaning of a companion, a friend, a lover?
Yes. So a companion would be somebody who keeps you company,
mm-hmm.
but may not have any obligations towards you as such. Whereas a friend would have certain level of expectations and expectations from you and would have some obligations as well. And a lover would have even higher level of obligations. And also expectations, obligations, and the degree of to which you freely express yourself would also vary.
Who understands you better? Your lover understands it, your friend understands it. A person who goes into loves you, he understands or she understands you better, or a friend understands you, or a companion.
So it could be anybody actually. Mostly either a friend or a lover would understand you more.
Okay. And who is the one who will go on to get worried if you're going to meet an accident or any type of an accident? What would be the response of a friend and a lover, both of them?
Both would be worried.
Okay, second will be?
However, a lover would worry a little more.
Okay, why not a friend?
A lover is somebody you want a future with, so he would worry. Maybe you're more intimate than you're actually
worried. Do you think that you're able to differentiate it clearly?
Almost.
Okay.
Divya, are you working now?
Yes.
You passed out in 2013.
Yes.
It's almost 2 years.
Yes,
you have not joined anymore?
No, sir.
Any specific reason why? Because in IAM you must be getting a lot of reference offers,
yes.
And you must be getting very good jobs.
Yes.
Any specific reason why?
So I did not join the industry yet because I feel that once you have a goal that you want to move towards, everything else becomes a distraction and would only distract you. So I figured I should first prepare for civil services, try my best, and then based on the results, I'll decide my future. We had the freedom to choose our courses, and I chose to not specialize in any field.
Okay.
I rather decided to get exposure in all the fields and more like general management.
General management.
Yes.
That's all. Okay. You said for the your placements.
Yes, sir.
You received what offers?
So I had a final offer from Jenpa.
And the placement was in? Best in India or just out of India?
In India, in Gurgaon.
So you did not plan only to pursue this civil service?
Yes.
And how long you are planning to pursue this? This is your second attempt? Or first?
Sir, this is my third attempt.
Third attempt.
Yes, sir. So, till the end of this year, I would concentrate my energies into civil services. And then I would decide the future course of action.
Actually, your hobbies are reading and music.
Yes.
What kind of books that interest you?
Mostly classics or young adult fiction. Yes, sir. So mostly fiction.
And music?
later the practicality of the situation can seep in maybe. But for now, I'd rather choose to be a little carefree and take the risk.
You have the support of your family?
Of my family, yes.
You are the only brother or you have siblings?
I have a brother.
What is he doing?
He is doing electrical engineering from MIT.
Okay. From the same institute where you are?
Yes.
One question from my side.
Yes, sir.
That is, how is it that you are going to be applying management in administration? Give this answer, but first differentiating between management and administration. Is it that they are the same or different?
So, they are different. Management relates more towards motivating, leading people, managing the efforts and resources that you have to achieve certain objectives and goals set by the organization, whereas administration would give would mean a greater responsibilities. It would also involve formulating some policies for the organization based on the vision that the organization may have. Also, administration is what every manager would need both these skills, management and administration. But as you climb up the hierarchy, administration would take a larger space of your work than management, and it is a lot riskier and is a job and requires more higher level of responsibilities compared to management.
Last, should you be picked up for civil services? If it is that, let's say the board wants to pick you for civil services, what do you think that you should go on to let the board know that you are a fit candidate for civil services? For what reason? And for what not reason? What reason should be picked up? For what reason you shouldn't be picked up?
Okay. Sir, I believe that civil services requires a motivation that lies more than that lies beyond the desire to
make it crisp. Make your reply crisp.
Okay. The reasons that you should pick me up would be that for me the motivation behind civil services is to serve the country and the people. I believe the civil services whose existence is based on the goal to serve people under the constitutional mandate of providing right to dignified life to every individual would provide a platform for me to serve my country in a much better way than I can in corporate world. And I feel...
Why should you be picked up? Reason number 1, 2, 3. And then reason number 1, 2, 3. Why shouldn't you be picked up? Make it simple.
So I believe in myself and I'm true to myself. I try to improve. I try to improve whenever I can, continuously. And the reasons I may not be picked up is I talk less. And over the years, maybe I have focused more on academics than in any other extracurricular activity. So maybe I'm a little narrow-minded.
Okay. Thank you, Divya. Thank you. We'll go on to call you for feedback.
It was bad.
Why is it that it went on to be bad?
So I think all my interviews usually go bad only because I fumble on words. I forget what I want to say. I say something else. Maybe, I don't know. I get nervous.
Why don't you make this much of a smell into the world normally?
I smile a lot, but I'm not sure if it's okay to laugh in interviews.
Now, who has asked you to prevent yourself to such an extent in not coming to your own terms in the interview?
You're not even natural self.
Yes, sir.
Someone has guided you for that?
No.
None?
No, it seems like that. That you have been told that you have to keep giving very serious countenance. Very serious, because we've been in a natural church, no? That was not the natural facility.
Yes.
First.
Yes.
Next, that initially you try to answer those questions in a structured manner.
Yes.
But once the situation becomes difficult for you, you have given up. Whenever somebody will start, one of the member of the interview board will start giving the level, they will raise the difficulty level for you. Just not, you could find that you are an introvert type of person, you speak less, and you are the last person to tell your requirement to your family. You are not coming forward, yes, this is my requirement, I have to do it. Somebody will make the situation difficult for you, then you will come back, then you will give up. Don't give up.
Yes, sir.
No, Divya, you are a technocrat, plus you have gone to the best master institute in India. So the level of expectation will be high.
Expectation of the board will be high.
Yes.
And especially for this thing is that first they will expect structure in your approach, and second thing, the employee will think you have got a very good problem-solving.
If you all the time fail, then when you lack?
Okay.
No?
Yes, sir.
Be concrete. And come up to the solution, whatever the best you can. In management, there must be so much group discussions.
Yes, sir. So
presentation.
Yes, sir.
And all those. Their expectation must be more from you.
See, I want to go a bit detailed on your part. Of course, your problem is expression. Expression at least in front of this board. Okay? Why is it that you went on to fumble? You know it better. But then you always go on to give a picture to any psychologist in the world that you haven't explored life. Okay? Had it been that you would have gone through all the maybe travels of life, all the dimensions of life, have you been a bit naughty sometimes, a bit boisterous sometimes, a bit genius sometimes, a bit intellectual sometimes, and everyone goes on to pass through that phase, then you would have been a different person altogether. Is it so?
Yeah.
Okay. No, use the word yes. Right? You get habituated to using this word. Now, it's not that your introvert is being a problem, but then you are in a closed shell. You again don't go on to, maybe even with the board, that you don't go to allow the board to explore you, to probe you, to block it there. So, board goes to develop a distance from you. Right? If you allow the board to maybe probe you a bit deeper, maybe you start working on that count and it will keep on moving, Okay. I think I'm able to correlate certain things. When Purushottam Agrawal came here, he went on to ask you specifically that whether you have any question to ask or not. Are you the same girl?
Sir.
Are you the same girl?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, I'm able to recall that part. Now that time also it was surprising for us. That is why is it not you're not asking a question, right? So, in front of so many people, you find it difficult to project yourself. Is it so?
To a large extent.
Not to a certain extent, to a large extent. That means, this means that you don't respect yourself. Right? And maybe there can be different reasons for it, but you seem to have gone through some type of mishap in your life somewhere. I don't need to know what exactly, but then you just have to say yes to that or no to that, whatever it is. Right?
Sir, it was a little different from others.
It was?
A little different from other people.
Yes. That's how exactly I'm going to say it. That is, that has affected you a lot, your self-esteem and your thinking and your approach towards life. I have not been able to recover from that to a large extent. What has happened is that you have stopped exploring the dimensions of life. Normal condition that you would have done this, stopped, done that. a variety of things. It's also that is you require to go through some type of a relapse type of situation, psychological relapse. Right? What this means is that maybe in your youthful period also you couldn't go on to spread yourself far and wide, climbing trees, doing this, doing that, all of it, this thing. That has affected your personality. Right? And talking about the knowledge part, I'll come later. I'm talking about your personality because it's all about personality. Right? So I'm going to take advantage of my being a psychologist also to a certain extent. Although this doesn't go to say anything of that type. But I hope both of us know that what we are talking about. You have to get over it. Take an example. If you have back to your wall, right, and a dog is running towards you, he is going to bite you. Can't go to climb the wall. What are you going to do? In your state of mind, you're going to give up. Or start shouting. Ostrich type of condition, you're going to bury your head in the teeth. Not mindful of the fact that someone can go to tear you apart. Right? You require to change this part, Divya. Okay? Both understand what you're talking about. This is called friendship.
Okay.
A friend is the one who understands you. If you're going to fall down, you're going to slap you tight. Jab dekho tab girta rehta hai. Ye girti rehti hai. Take you to hospital as well. Your lover will start crying, you have no what to do. Right? That's the difference. Okay? Why exactly I went to ask you this question, you can go to understand this better now. Why is it that I went to ask you this question? And why is it that I was not expecting a proper reply from you as well? Right? Because having proved your personality that way, I could go to guess that part. I let you know, there is no one in this world who has not seen a very bad time. No one in this world who has never been insulted. No one in this world will not go to see the pinnacles of life. No one. Give me any person. The only constant in your life is change. Right? Unless you're going to pass through this situation, if your mind is strong, you will going to convert this situation into some type of learning opportunity. If it is not, you will perish. You understand? Hindi, do you listen to Hindi songs?
To Hindi songs?
No. No, yes.
Yes, sir, I do.
You do. Then, if you recall one of these songs from one of these films, Dur Hai Kinara, Gehri Nadi Ki Dhara, Tuti Teri Naiya, Maji Khete Jaore. If you're going to give up, you're going to find a shore. That is your limit. That's your choice. If you don't give up, you'll keep on moving. Anytime you give up, you're going to land on the shore. That's the end of it. It's your choice whether you want to give it up or you want to take it ahead. It's your choice ultimately. Right? Want to give it up?
No, I don't want to.
No? I'm making you realize these things because you are in a process of giving up. Process of giving up. Civil services think, okay, but I'm going to go to management. This attitude is not good. You're capable of it. You have been to this level. You are going to be into, you are going to be at the threshold of some of the best services that the country is offering. You are capable of it and you have all the conditions maybe tailor-made for you as well. Why is it that you have to think in this manner that you are going to give it up? You said to this answer? Give this answer? Right? Are you wondering how is it that I have come to know about so many things? Are you wondering? No, you're not wondering. So, you want to be friends with me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, why? Why? Tell me why.
The answer to most of my questions is yes.
Okay. To get all these answers that I've asked you or any reason, give me a, now you can go to give me a proper answer from your heart. Why is it that you want to be a friend with me?
Because I
You want?
It might help.
So you might help.
It might help.
Okay. It has to come from within. Your strength is, again, your expression. And the weakness is, again, your expression. Both of them. Right? When you wish to express, but then in order to express, you require to be in a complete happy state of mind. We're going to talk a lot, start moving about, and your body language is going to become very attentive. Now, that is when you are normally at your best. Right? Now, what is it that we can go to do to make you happy? That is the only help that we can go to offer to you. What you could have done was that any of these questions that have been asked, let's say Flamenco, let's say Spanish round, okay? Western Indian management, you can structure your thought. Your structuration part of the thought has been missing. It's largely because you are a bit unorganized in your mind. And you're unorganized because a lot of things go on to be in your subconscious, so that is affecting your thinking. That is, you have to qualify, you have to show your identity to the people, to the world. Kisko dikha diya, usko dikha diya, that's the reason, right?
So I don't think that is the reason.
Sorry?
I don't think that is the reason.
Okay. That means you have to show your identity, you have to flaunt your identity. Not exactly kisko dikha
diya. But I'm not sure if my identity is something that I can show. I mean, there are certain expectations, like you said.
From yourself. Right? You have made this expectation from yourself. Computer engineering, you were not able to answer this question, no issue. But when you have been asked why should you be picked up for the civil services, then your answer has to be very clear. That is, you can go to say, the best answer in this case would have been, sir, I have certain characteristics. Sometimes these characteristics can go to be advantage to me, sometimes they can be disadvantage to me. Sometimes they can be disadvantaged, for example, I'm cool, I'm a bit calm, I don't speak too much, I'm a bit introvert. That can go on to help me introspect a lot, and allow me to understand people better, perhaps. But sometimes they can be disadvantaged if I have to go for public appearances and talk to a lot of people. That is balancing. Okay. Second is, I go to read a lot, so consequently I may be good for policy making, but I may not be good for field, possibly. Right? Third can be that is being a girl, I'm very sensitive, I have a lot of empathy, that goes on to be an advantage for a civil servant. Maybe because I am a girl, that can go on to put me to certain type of disadvantage as well. I will come to know only when I'm going to be working as a part of a civil services. Get it? Now, that's the way that you start going ahead. The suggestion from my side will be pick up someone, and leave apart your logic. Don't apply your logic. Right now, don't apply your logic. And talk. Talk your hearts out. Find a place where you can go to confess a lot of things, ease yourself. Right? Okay? Find someone whom you can go to pick it up for the purpose of maybe saying anything, so that you are able to cleanse yourself. Right? Certain type of toxicity of thoughts in your mind may be affecting you negatively, despite the fact that you are talented enough. So your attitude some way is coming in way of suppressing your talent. And there's no doubt that you're talented. Your attitude will be that you allow your talent to bloom. Right? That is what we can go to suggest now, today. But you have been diagnosed. Medication also you have been referred. One of them, two of them essentially. We are not able to offer you all the medication because that will go to require maybe a lot of things, but then it is up to you to take that medication. Okay. Anything that you think that you need to ask from the board? Anyone?
Think a bit.
Maybe you can go to take a piece of a paper. To one or two answers which require a structured reply, ask a board. Maybe they can go to give you a piece of paper. maybe that you can allow yourself to think, and then think on what lines. A structuration is essentially, it should have been essentially a part of your coaching process. I don't know whether you have gone through a coaching process or not, and even if it is gone through, your thoughts have not been structured. You have got everything by and large from here, there, everything, but somewhere either you have not been able to understand it, or they have not been able to make you understand it as well. Somewhere that is a major flaw. So you have some information. Your insights are very good. For example, with respect to farmers, you talk about subsistence farming and other things. That was a good insight. So you are insightful, but then somewhere you have missed the bus, or you have been allowed to miss the bus, or you have been, because you have been completely unidimensional, that's the reason you have not been able to understand that part. Right? So talk to people, and anything that you're going to come to know through them, start structuring yourself. I don't know what books and other things that you have studied, but then take an example. The best thing that I will go on to do is, I was just talking to Arunji on that count. Allow you in the class, give your topic, ask you to give a lecture to the class once, twice, thrice. If you want to take care of your problem. That was a program of this type, Total Transformation Program. I don't know whether it goes on to be still there or not. Whether we are going at, Malik will go to let you know on that part. Mm-hmm. But that is what exactly you require. Try to find someone.
Is there somebody who is appearing in the interview along with you, some of the person to whom you know?
I don't know.
She has completely separated herself from
that. That seems the reason. Second thing, whether did you appear in interview last in any of the UPSC interview last time?
No, sir.
Have not appeared. Your brother is how old? He just studied in engineering. When is your interview?
Sir, the date is not out yet.
I think it must be in the month of July only.
No, not July. 22nd.
June.
It should be
June. After 29th May. Definitely. You are having, much time with you. That is going in your advantage. Knowledge base is not that poor. Knowledge base is good. But
I'm going to put his words in a different manner. With whatever knowledge base, you can still go on to do it very well. It's not a way of talking about poor or good, but whatever knowledge base you have, it's better than a good number of students.
Only one thing is there, that the expectation of the interview board will be high.
Yes.
So for that, you require more practice. Sometimes it happens that you are having some shortcomings, but by practice, you can overcome those things. Practice means you just have almost 100 questions right now, which are related to this Kajata only. Rajasthan, mother is from Uttar Pradesh, problems of Delhi, scheduled tribes, which are the scheduled tribes in Uttarakhand, which are the other Rajasthan, what the problems they are having, your biodata, management, computer engineering, all the topics are there. In every topic, give a write-up. And practice that.
Okay.
As if you are giving a class to the students. In a structured form, you pick up 10, 12, 15 sentences over that.
Okay.
And speak.
Yes.
By this articulation, I think it will help you to some extent. Or if you are having video camera, get it video out also. Then you see your own performance, but how you are doing. Get inspiration that now I will do better than whatever I have just spoken. Again get a video out. Then see what the difference you have got. Then again, 3-4 times. I think by this way, some betterment will come in your articulation. You will find that where I should take a pause, why I am using this word more often, why I am not convincing. You just see across the camera. Yes. You must be having this type of mobile also, no?
Yes.
Tell somebody this, and I am speaking for 2 minutes on this topic. And you speak, then see.
Okay.
I think this way it will
help.
You get to believe in yourself, that will make you more convincing, and that will make you more...
Record some of the classes on YouTube, your own class.
Okay.
You speak something, record on YouTube, and see by yourself. question, intuition. That type of perception, there are some persons who are not opening up. They are having the knowledge, but they are hiding them, so they are cocooned, introvert. So you have to speak up. Then only it will help.
Her expressions now were very different from when she came for the interview. And I may ask you one question. I mean, you don't have to speak that way. You can go to nod your head as well. Do you have your respect for the male community a bit lower, generally? I say that, is it that your respect for the male community is lower?
Respect for male community. Sir, I studied in an all-girls school.
All-girls school?
Yes,
sir. She's awed by the perspective. She's not lower, no. She's awed, the feeling of awe is coming. She's not making eye contact. She's giving the side way. She doesn't come vociferously. Yes, this is the he may stand. Never participated in debating.
If you had left yourself, Kishatan Karo, the Masi Karo, independent of the world, what will you want to do?
I won't do.
This is what you have to do. This is what you have to do. Maybe supposing you want to do that and that goes on to help you qualify for the interview. You want to do it or not? Is it worth? Is it worth becoming naughty if it goes to help you qualify for the interview?
Yes,
go on. Explore yourself. Right? Let the whole world know that there is a girl called as Divya. What? Divya Rawat. Right? Okay?
Yes.
So, are you living in Rajanagar?
Sir, I stay in Janakpuri.
In Janakpuri.
Yes.
So, okay. In Janakpuri, let the people know that there is a girl called as Divya Rawat. Okay? You should win news now in 5, 6, 7, 10 days.
From that area, Kangana Ranaut came in different queen, no? It was nearby, Kangana Ranaut.
Janakpuri.
And the story is from Janakpuri or from Rajouri Garden, like that.
Do everything that you have not done so far. If you want to qualify this exemption. And just go to follow me. You will be successful. It's an unconventional method, but then I'm not a conventional person as well.
Yes, sir.
Right?
So I have scheduled like 3 interviews in sets.
Here?
So, yes, sir.
Okay. But before next interview,
yes,
at least have your 5, not 10, 10 lectures of 2 minutes recorded on YouTube.
Okay.
And bring that one in your mobile.
Okay.
You want to see that, or was the first one or what? 10th one.
Okay.
That will help you.
Okay.
Related to this one. 2 minutes.
Okay.
And let everybody to listen it also. Your mother, father, just see I have recorded how it is.
Abhi mother, father ko helpful nahi honge Ramji iske liye.
नहीं मदर फादर फिर भी कॉन्सलिंग बड़ा फादर
हाँ कॉन्सलिंग कर सकते मदर फादर फिर
भी नहीं बोल रही है और
अभी इसको चाहिए कुछ है कि जो जिसके साथ में वो बातें कर सकते हैं जो बातें अपने पापा मम्मी के साथ नहीं कर पाती है इसको वही चाहिए व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज गोइंग इन योर माइंड राइट नाउ Brother is your closest one.
Yes.
Okay. Is it that he teaches you?
So
allow him to.
Sometimes.
Arey bichari ko allow karo. Allow him. Right? Thik?
Okay.
Next time you want to see a different Divya.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes,
and you don't have to. You just have to break your shells. That is it.
Okay.
Right?
Yes, okay.
And if you, in case you want to find a friend, we'll go to advertise for you. Now that is the naughtiness that you have to get.
Okay.
Get it?
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, straight. Right.
Yes. Okay.
Make 2 walks here and there.
Okay.
Not this way. You don't have to go for a ramp walk. Bit straight.
Sir.
Put your hands down.
Yes.
Walk. Yes, again? No, it has to be improved. You have loosened your body completely. Be a bit straight. Will you go for morning walk?
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow you are going to go left